Principal Deputy Assistant Secretary Garriott, please proceed.
Hello, good afternoon, Chairman Schatz, Vice Chairman Murkowski. In my language, I say, Chante washte nape chuzapalo. I greet you with a good heart. My name is Wizipunk Lelout Garriott. I serve as the Principal Deputy Assistant Secretary for Indian Affairs at the U.S. Department of the Interior. Thank you for the opportunity to present the department's testimony supporting increased efforts to address violence in Indian Country through implementation of the Tribal Special Domestic Violence Criminal Jurisdiction Provisions in the Violence Against Women Act. This is an issue that is close to my heart. Many of my relatives have experienced hurt and trauma, including abuse as a child, domestic abuse, and even human trafficking at the hands of both Indian and non-Indian perpetrators. Sadly, living in fear is all too often the reality for many in Indian Country. As members of this committee are aware, American Indians and Alaska Natives are more than 2 times as likely to experience violent crimes and at least 2 times more likely to experience rape or sexual assault and crimes than all of their other ethnicities. Violence does not happen in a vacuum, and this is why the Biden-Harris administration and the department support the expansion of tribal criminal jurisdiction beyond crimes of domestic violence as provided for in H.R. 1620, the Violence Against Native Women Act reauthorization. In line with this commitment, the department is working to reduce rates of domestic violence and violence against American Indian and Alaska Native people, collaborate with tribes and law enforcement agencies to equip tribes with the resources to respond to violence at the community level, implement models of tribal restorative justice, provide violence prevention services to diminish cycles of violence, and directly assist tribes with solving active and unsolved missing persons and homicide cases. And also working to through the Bureau of Indian Affairs Office of Justice Services to implement the Missing and Murdered Indigenous Peoples Unit and to fulfill the requirements of the Savannah's Act, the Not Invisible Act, and the President's Executive Order on addressing the Missing and Murdered Indigenous Peoples Crisis. Assisting tribes with implementation of VAWA 2013 is another critical part of the department's commitment to addressing this epidemic. To date, 28 tribal governments maintain domestic violence jurisdiction over non-Indians, and many more tribal governments are in varying stages of planning and implementation. BIA-OJS provides support to those tribes currently implementing VAWA, as well as those with prospects for implementation. Despite the successes of VAWA 2013, jurisdictional gaps persist across Indian Country. Many domestic violence cases involve children who were present in the home during alleged incidents. According to the Pascua-Yaqui tribe, from 2014 to 2017, 32 children, all under the age of 11, were exposed to violence, were victims, or reported the crime while it was in progress. Pascua-Yaquis are not numbers are not unique, and they demonstrate the need for tribal criminal jurisdiction to be expanded to include crimes against children. The time has come to honor tribal sovereignty and expand tribal criminal jurisdiction. H.R. 1620 provides for the expansion of tribal criminal jurisdiction beyond crimes of domestic violence to include crimes of dating violence, obstruction of justice, sexual violence, sex trafficking, stalking, and assault of law enforcement and correctional officers. Importantly, this legislation expands tribal criminal jurisdiction to crimes against children. Since time immemorial, Native nations have maintained effective justice systems. Today, tribal governments and courts continue to prove they are best suited. And this is why the department is pleased to support expansion of criminal jurisdiction to tribes in Maine and in Alaska. Due to remote nature and limited resources, many Alaska Native villages providing for public safety and law enforcement services remains a big challenge. Many villages lack enforcement, and in many cases must wait days for law enforcement response to an incident. The department understands and appreciates the unique jurisdictional and resource challenges faced by Alaska Native tribes. The administration and the department are firmly committed to working with tribal governments and this committee to meaningfully improve public safety and justice for all tribes. Thank you for the opportunity to testify today, and we'd be happy to answer any questions the committee may have.
Thank you very much, Mr. Garriott.